What's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, I'm going to take you guys down to Australia. You're going to see a sunrise like no other. Also have some video footage out of Melbourne, Australia by Mike Barron of three, quite possibly four, unusual crafts flying through the daytime sky. We're going to take a look at some more rocket launch footage out of Florida from yesterday's rocket launch off the east coast of Florida. Some close-up videos there of the rocket as it was just taking off the east coast. The Schumann resonance yesterday was lit up like a light bulb. The data is still in supercharged mode. It's slowed down in the last 3 hours, but you can see there was a major spike in the Schumann that lasted the better part of 24 hours. Coming back over here to the website, I'd like to wish a few people happy Earth Day today. James Stegman, Mary T. Barnett, Andrew Diego, Elizabeth Bottoms, also goes by Ironic Optimist. Happy birthday, guys. May 7th of 2022. Hope you guys have a great day. Coming back to the website, looking at the GOES X-ray flux. No major flares in the last 24 hours. Looking at the Earth-facing side of the sun at the Solar Dynamics Observatory. A couple of sunspots turning away from the Earth off the southwestern limb of the sun. Have some new ones approaching over here in the southeastern quadrant of the sun. And this one here is growing. Not very fast, but it is growing a little bit right now as I do this video. Coming over to poweroutage.us, outages in Texas and Pennsylvania. Both of those are weather-related. Hopping over to the Yellowstone Supervolcano Caldera, looking at the seismographs that monitor the mighty supervolcano. Seeing a little bit of earthquake activity today on multiple seismographs. Once again, the earthquake activity is primarily on the eastern side of the supervolcano caldera. Blue represents magma intrusion, but nothing major going on at the supervolcano. Lake Mead Water Database, once again, seeing a new record low May 6th of 2022, elevation at 1,053.29, the outflow of 18,800, superseded the inflow of 10,046 for yet another negative reading. That is, once again, a new all-time record low at the Hoover Dam. I want to take you guys now down to Melbourne, Australia. This video footage was sent in by Mike Barron of some objects flying through the daytime sky. I don't think these are airplanes because you don't hear any noise. I do actually have volume on with this video. He noticed these things flying through the daytime sky above Melbourne. I believe there's four. Look like some sort of a disc to me. They don't look like airplanes and definitely don't sound like airplanes. If those were jets, they would be very loud. They appear to be metallic. You can see light reflecting off of these objects, whatever they are. This is an enhanced format. And you can see what almost looks like a vertical tail on the back end of these things, whatever they may be. Don't claim to know, just passing them along. Video footage taken by Mike Barron out of Melbourne, Australia from a few days ago. Three, maybe four objects quietly moving through the sky of southern Australia. Speaking of Australia, Queensland, Australia from April 22nd of 2022. And he said the camera really did not do this any justice. There was what looked like a large pink, almost a semi-transparent ball up in the sky ahead of the sunrise. This is sunrise looking east off of the east coast of Australia in the Queensland area, Dalby, Queensland, in fact. And that is super rare. You don't see that very often. In fact, I don't think I've ever seen a sunrise quite like that. You have one patch of the sky that's almost a bright pink. And again, he said the camera didn't pick up all of the activity. I guess there was more concentrated pink in this area here. And then obviously blue and gold. And then as you can see, some white clouds in the area. Blue sky behind the clouds. And then you've got this large area of what looks like a pink vapor in the sky at sunrise, visible from Dalby, Queensland, Australia. Going back down to Florida, this is from yesterday morning around 5:15 a.m. Video footage by Jamisha out of Jacksonville, Florida. This is right as the rocket was launching off the southeastern coast of Florida. And she says, OMG, she didn't know what she was looking at the time it occurred. And they are quite the spectacle if you've ever seen one. Nestor C. saw it all the way from Orlando, Florida. This again was captured around the same time the video you just saw was taken up in Jacksonville, Florida. This one here was out of Orlando, Florida. That is unedited exactly the way I received it. Very dramatic skies this morning, visible from most of the state of Florida. Also in this video, I've got a brand new picture slideshow, new sky phenomena photos sent in from all around the world. First photo sent in by Shayla out of Wichita, Kansas, of a jumbo series of pink clouds after storms rolled through the area. This would have been at sunset in Wichita, Kansas. Sunrise out of Alberta, Canada. Photo sent in by Roy T. Another photo of the sun. This is sunset sent in by Mark out of Kansas. Went from orange to pink, and these are unedited exactly the way I received the photos. Photo here by Live Life out of Vancouver Island off the coast of British Columbia. You can see a very obvious big circle in the daytime sky. Photo here by myself from right out here in Arizona of a jumbo halo in the sky. Bobby K out of Middle Tennessee, a horizontal rainbow in the sky above Middle Tennessee. Also above Monroe, Alabama by Chris, who noticed what looks like the same exact thing. Annalena out of Frankfort, Kentucky also noticed a horizontal rainbow in the sky. Durango, Colorado, photo sent in by Stuart of the recent conjunction of Jupiter and Venus in the early morning sky. Here's another photo by Roger R. from April 30th of 2022. These next photos were sent in by Liz B. out of New York of some colorful clouds high in the sky above New York. Then a fiery orange sunset also visible from New York. Cindy B. out of Kansas looked like a big white wafer in the sky. Look at the contrast there between the clear blue sky and then the thick white clouds. And then you can see the edge of the cloud in the daytime sky. Kind of a rare observation there when you see where the two fronts collide. Not something you see every day. Great job, guys. Keep the photos and videos coming. If you have any photos you'd like to share, you can send those to reports at MrMBB333.com. Thanks for watching. Have a super day and be safe out there.